Hi, I'm Scott Pigg with Seventh Wave, and I'm here today to give you my perspective on an interesting research project that we recently completed on high energy using homes in Minnesota. Now, this was a project that we did with a grant from the Minnesota Conservation Applied Research and Development Program with the cooperation of several Minnesota utilities. And what it involved was getting electricity and natural gas data for all homes in four Minnesota communities, and then marrying up that usage data with property tax information, identifying high energy users, and then visiting a sample of those high energy users to collect data on contributors to high energy use and energy savings opportunities. And the goals of this project were to better understand the factors that contribute to high energy use, to look at savings opportunities and the potential for savings in high using homes, and then to identify program strategies that might be specific to this segment of the population. Now, my particular role in this project had three parts to it. First, I was involved in some of the high level statistical analysis of the usage data and the property tax information on square footage and home age. And second, after we had recruited 100 homes where we were going to do on-site visits to get data, I developed a profile for each home based on the usage patterns for that home, the property tax information, and public imagery like from Google Street View or Google Earth that we could send out with our field staff before they went into the home. And one of the more interesting and fun parts of that piece of the work was that while I was developing each one of those profiles, I kept a secret list of what I thought might be some energy saving opportunities in that home just based on the information that I had on hand at the time before we had ever set foot in the home. And in a couple minutes, I'll give you more insight into how successful we were in identifying those opportunities. So what did we find that was interesting from this study? I'll start with natural gas high users. For me, this study really confirmed the value of having home size and home age when you're trying to look for savings opportunities and target high natural gas users. We all know in Minnesota that most of the natural gas consumption is for space heating, and that space heating scales with home size. And if you start with a list of high natural gas users, and in our study we defined high natural gas as 1,200 therms per year or higher, what you'll find is that you'll end up with 30% to 40% of those homes are simply large homes, and many of those are new large homes that have limited opportunities. But if you can get your hands on square footage and home age information, now you can winnow that list down of targeted homes to homes that have high heating energy use per square foot or high heating energy intensity. And the data that we gathered from this study and what other research that we've done support is that the higher the heating energy intensity of a home, the greater the opportunity for energy savings. And in fact, when homes that participate in programs, we actually see higher energy savings from high heating intensity homes. So to me, it's a real no-brainer that if you're trying to target homes for high natural gas savings, what you're really looking for is to get that square footage information so that you can zero in on high intensity homes. And I will say that it was not that hard to get our hands on bulk information about square footage and home age. Now, we were working with four pretty discrete communities, so we could just go straight to the tax assessor's office and get all that data at a pretty nominal fee, and we were successful in marrying that up with the utility billing systems for about 80% to 90% of the homes. And it really only took 1 or 2 days worth of work to link up property tax and billing system data for somewhere in the neighborhood of 40,000 homes. Now, for utilities with wider geographic interests, there are data aggregators out there that are happy to sell you the same sort of information on a wider geographic scale. And I'll also say that the site data showed us that the square footage data that you get from tax records was reasonably accurate, at least for our purposes. We really don't care about square footage down to the last square foot or even 100 square feet. What we're really looking for is the difference between a 1,500 square foot home and a 3,500 square foot home. And the data that we got was great for that purpose. So what about electricity? What we found there is that for targeting opportunities in high electric users, having square footage and home age was not as useful. For electricity, there's just a lot more end uses in homes and a lot more ways to be a high user and fewer ways that high use scales with home age and home size. Now, to be sure, homes that use electricity for space heating or who use a lot of air conditioning, there is a size component to it. But at least in Minnesota, those are not dominant contributors to electricity consumption. So from my perspective, if you're trying to target electric savings opportunities, the square footage and home age data is useful, but not nearly as useful as it is for natural gas. By the same token, targeting high electric users does lead you to finding lots of electricity savings opportunities. And one of the other eye-openers for me for this project was the kinds of opportunities that we found in these homes, both on the natural gas side and the electricity side. We weren't really sure before we went into the homes whether we were going to find a lot of idiosyncratic causes of high usage, like somebody operating a welding shop out of their garage or having a ginormous hot tub in the backyard. And we did find a little bit of that, but by and large, what we found was the same kinds of opportunities that are already being targeted by most energy efficiency programs. We just found a lot more of them. We're talking about things like homes that have mostly incandescent lighting in them, that have multiple refrigerators, that are using electric space heaters more than normal. And on the gas side, lots of homes that have insulation defects, have high air leakage, and have inefficient heating systems. And by the way, we looked at about 36 different energy saving opportunities, some of which were technical opportunities like adding insulation or replacing an inefficient air conditioner, and some of which were behaviorally oriented, and those were things like turning the thermostat down in the winter or turning off appliances that are left on. And when we look at the aggregate savings across all of those opportunities that we found, about 2/3 of them were on the technical side and 1/3 were on the behavioral side. Okay, now back to my little secret list. How good did I do at predicting energy savings opportunities in Minnesota homes? Well, I can tell you that I was more than a little nervous that there would end up being no correlation between what I predicted and what we actually found in the homes, and I would look like a big old idiot. But I'm happy to report that I did better than chance. And in particular, it seems like just looking at home imagery, usage patterns, and publicly available tax information, you can do a pretty good job of predicting opportunities for air sealing and insulation on the gas side. Now, of course, you could argue reasonably that those are not exactly rocket science opportunities, because if you're looking at an older home that has very high heating use per square foot, the odds are very good that it's going to have some insulation defects and air sealing opportunities. But I can also say that we did better than chance at predicting use of electric space heaters that could perhaps be eliminated. And most surprising to me, we did better than chance at identifying gas fireplaces where the pilot lights are left on during the summer, which would otherwise seem like a fairly minor thing to pick out of utility usage data. My two biggest disappointments were that we had no predictive ability to identify low-efficiency heating systems that could use replacement, and we, on the electric side, We did not do a good job at identifying homes with multiple refrigerators and freezers that could be targets for removal or replacement. All in all, I thought it was a very interesting study. We learned a lot. If you find this video interesting, I encourage you to watch the other two short videos in this series by my colleagues Jeanette Lazax and Claire Cowan. We also have a longer 90-minute webinar that we did some time ago that covers some aspects of this study in more detail. And then finally, we have a final report that you can download and look at. So thanks for watching. Take care.